What's up, guys? Wolf here, dreaming about against Jamie from the Team Equinox chat. Just a standard battle. I use 2 OUs, he's like 4, but I don't really care. So he's leading off with a for alligator, I'm leading off with my Volbeat, which is my trick Volbeat if you did remember. I'm pretty sure you did, because I used it in the last battle and stuff. He goes with the Ice Punch, and he switches out. I should have Focus Punch here, predicting the switch. But I didn't, which kind of failed. But oh well, I switch out, making the safe move, going to Skarm, which is not gay. It's a Sword Stance agility set, which you will see. Hopefully, I will get to use in my next standard battle. Go to my Flygon, take the Stone Edge like a beast, but he gets a crit, unfortunately. But I don't really care. I go for the Specs Earth Power for the win. Doesn't KO because of Paranitar's. Boosted defensive sandstorm. He goes for the crunch and takes me out. So yeah, sorry my voice is a bit low right now. I'm trying to speak up, but it's quite late at night and I don't quite want to disturb anybody. So he goes into he goes into Mets, switches out Tyrant, starting with Mets. I go for the U-turn, doesn't do jack, and I go into my Spirit Soul, which is my new Spirit Tomb. Which is a pretty good set. Gets walled by normal types though. I'm probably gonna change it up a little bit, but it's like this for now. So set up a sub, and yeah. He goes into Machamp, and I know Machamp can't do all that much to me. Goes through the Ice Punch, and breaks my sub. And I go through Wisp, and he carries a Lumberry, which is pretty weird. But it caught me off guard, so that was good enough for him. So, yeah. He goes for the Stone Edge. I set up a sub again, because I know I can live. No, wait, I go for the Pain Split here. And I get quite a lot of health and do a reasonable amount of damage to him, or if that's what you call it. So, yeah. He goes for the Stone Edge again, and it takes me down quite low. I set up a sub again and takes me down really low. I barely live the sandstorm. He goes for the Ice Punch, raising the sub, and I go for the pain. Go for the Pain Split, I believe. Yeah, I do, and I get some health back. So now I'm going to switch out of here, predicting a Stone Edge, because I don't quite want my Spirit Tomb to die so early in the game. Go to my Hitmontop, Coffee Top version 2, which is version 2 of my old Coffee Top, my choice bandit Hitmontop, which I haven't used in a long time. I probably will use it again some other battle. So yeah, this is a revenge killing Hitmontop, which is just a standard smoking set, which is bleh. I don't really care. I don't use all that many smoking sets anymore, but I do have a few. Box. But, yeah. So, I go into Ventful, but he goes into Shuckle. He tries to encore me, but it doesn't work, because, you know, I'm pro like that. I go for Focus Punch, predicting him to do stuff. I was feeling the knockoff, but it didn't. So, I go for the trick here. Trick him a life, or life of Shuckle for the win. He goes for a knockoff, knock off my leftover, which doesn't really matter, just makes me die earlier. And yeah, I go for the T-Punch because that's the only move I can use to hurt it, because I know he's going to knock off again and I can't go for the Focus Punch, so yeah, that kind of sucks. So anyways, I'm going to die from, Sandstorm, and I go to my Sandslash, set up my Stealth Rocks. Now he goes under Scarf for Alligator, which I tricked him, and for some reason he goes with an Ice Punch, which I don't know why he did. His Waterfall has more power and stab, unless he doesn't carry Waterfall, which is probably unlikely. He probably carries Waterfall. I don't know why he went for the Ice Punch today. I should ask him sometime when I see him again. So yeah, he switches out and goes into Flygon. I switch out as well, go to Coffee Top version 2. Stuff's happening. Go for the fake out for free damage, and he gets the flinch, obviously, and stuff. Now he goes for the fire blast, predicting my switch into Skarm, And I don't know why I was switching to Skarm. He probably thinks I'm a standard dumb Skarm set. But I just go for the revenge and kill him off, which is pretty good. So, yeah. This is an immense. I switch out, go to my Sand Slash. Which will happen in a second. Yeah, I go to Sand Slash, this is the TD, and stuff is happening. I don't know what I should say. See, this is a Dragon Claw. It doesn't kill me because Sand Slash is so beastly. I live it, and I go for Stone Edge's misses, which doesn't really matter all that much, because it just doesn't. He goes for Dragon Claw and KOs me. Too bad I didn't get any Sand Veil hacks. If I did, it'd be really hilarious because Sand Slash does have the ability Sand Veil, I believe. And yeah, so he went to my Coffee Top version 2 and he goes into his Relegator. I go to Fake Out for free damage and I'm going to kill him off next turn with a Mach Punch. And basically, I'm going to sweep the rest of his team. So that's a really good game, Jamie. I've had a lot of fun. At the beginning, I was kind of losing. A long battle this was. I definitely enjoyed the match. Hope you all did as well. So, yeah. See you guys later, I believe. Oh, by the way, if you actually manage to watch to the end, like here, I will be going to... I'm gonna be going out to Disneyland for 2 days because my cousins are visiting and I'm gonna bring them there. At least my parents are. Or my family is. Who cares? So that's a really good game, Jamie. And comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys later, I guess. Yeah. Peace out, guys. Goodbye. If I call her name.